really the desktop into the browser. Next up, we have Teresa Mayfield-Meyer. Teresa is the Arctos Community Coordinator. Need any help with that? And we'll be hearing about Arctos Collection Management, Publication, and Community in support of the extended specimen.
Is this working? Yeah, okay. Okay, everybody. First of all, I'll introduce Arctos for those of you that don't know it. It's a collection management system, web-based. And you can see here our just main public search page. So I am not gonna log in today. The things I'm going to show you are, you can go do at home if you so choose. One thing about Arctos is it's developed by a community. So all of the members that use the system are actively developing it at all times. And in this main search bar, you can see the little drop down are all the multiple ways you can search Arctos, but also it's representative of our standards. So most of the items on this list are some kind of standard code table, if you will, that is developed by the community. So this keeps our data standardized, normalized, and makes things easy to find. Recently, the community has been struggling with the problem of, oh, one of our collections or institutions has part of a bird and another one has the other part. And we're publishing these things to aggregators. And within Arctos, it's easy for us to relate those two things. But when the data leaves, it's not always obvious outside of Arctos that these two things are the same organism. So I'm gonna move over here to portals. The portals list is a list of all the collections that are represented in Arctos. So right now there's 276 collections, like 4 million catalog records. And this allows you to easily search individual collections by, you know, just picking them. You can also, from the main search page, pick one or five or all of them if you want to search the whole thing. So today I'm going to talk about this special collection right here that's called, the institution is Arctos Consortium. So it's a collection that's shared by everybody in the community. And essentially what it's doing is, get the right one, is letting us create or mint organism IDs. This is how it first came about. And we didn't really want to be in this business, but we've kind of figured out that it's the only way we can get this done. So the entity collection works like any other collection. It's just a catalog record. The only thing that's different are the way the record looks and what it does. It does something a little different than the other catalog records. So if we go look at this one, there's a big old map at the top, which is, people are infatuated with maps. I don't know. I kind of don't care. But basically what this entity does is it says, here's all the Arctos catalog records that share this ID for whatever reason. And in this case, they share this ID because it's an organism ID. So this is a banded bird that was captured several times. So it has some observation records. And at one point it also had blood drawn from it. So it has also a physical object. So these are all in the same collection, but they're different catalog records because they happened at different times. So if we take a look at one of the components of this entity, when you go to the catalog record, and this is the one for the blood sample, you can see we've got some identifiers here. This particular individual has several identifiers. One is the bird banding number, but it has this organism ID, which is just the URL for that entity record. And what happens with that, what's kind of cool about it, is if I go to GBIF and search occurrences, but do advanced. And then I pick organism ID and go put that URL in there for the entity. Searching. I think it is anyway. Maybe not. Well, darn it. Let's try it one more time. See if I got the whole thing in there. Oh, it's not working. Well, it worked for me last night. Anyways, typically the four records would pop up right here. So that in that way, at GBIF, if somebody makes a big download of data, they can tell that they have four records all from a unique individual, not four different individuals, which is the thing that we were trying to overcome. So as we were working on this, we came across other kind of interesting ways for using it. And one of them is really fun. So at Colorado, they had a jar of shrews, 10 shrews in the jar. And at some point, somebody was doing some kind of work in the jar and said, oh, I found all these fleas. But which one of the shrews did the fleas come from? We don't really know. But we know it's from one of these 10. So they creatively made an entity that brings together these 10 shrews that are in the same jar and then made them the host of all the fleas that came out of that jar. So I thought that was a really creative use of that. Then there comes the, what happens when we aren't just talking Arctos institutions? And this is where, this is in a way, a call for participation and collaboration. Because we do have that occasion. And this is one right here. I'm gonna go to the bird record so you can see. So this owl is at MVZ. And at some point in time, you can see down here where the parts are, the skin was transferred. And it was transferred to AM&H. And the reason I know that is because here's the AM&H number. So ideally, the organism that we've created for this, the Arctos entity, if AM&H could put that URL in their organism ID, then the same thing would happen at GBIF, where everybody could see that when you download this, you don't have two different owls. You have just part of the same owl that's at two different places. The problem is AM&H doesn't have a field in their database for organism ID. So until that happens, we can't do this with them. But one of the things that we're trying to do at this point is put a call out. Do you have something that a duplicate of or another part of is in any of the Arctos collections, which you can see if you go to that portal page, what they all are. And you can use an organism ID. Then we're happy to create an entity so that we can mash our stuff together. I'm really mad this GBIF thing's not working. It's a bummer. Let's try something different. So, yeah. So from our Arctos record, we have links straight to GBIF and iDigBio, which is nice because one of the things that I use this a lot for is to figure out when somebody complains about data at one of the aggregators, is what happened. Is there something lost in translation? Like, are we putting something in the wrong place? Or do we just have something that's wrong? What's going on? It's nice. Let's see what we have in here. It's got the organism ID right there, so something's going on at GBIF. So, but also, because it's a hot link that we basically are sending the link to the aggregators, then from there, anybody can just come back to the entity and see what's happening. So ideally, we would also like to link up with whatever other piece of the organism is elsewhere. Or the fleas that are at your institution that came from the jar of shrews, like that kind of thing. On what? Oh, on Jiva? Oh, good catch. How did that happen? There we go. So yeah, when it works, it's great. But like I say, it's a problem we've been trying to solve for a long time. I feel like we've kind of come up with a solution, although it sort of leaves us in the position of being responsible now for these organism identifiers. And like I say, we really didn't want to do that, but at some point we felt like we had to if we were gonna, you know, make this kind of thing start to work. So I'll be here for questions after. Really appreciate your time.